CNN political commentator and Trump supporter Paris Denard. Also, Charles Kaiser is with us. He's a CNN.com contributor and the author of multiple books, including The Cost of Courage, the story of how one French family fought the Nazis during the Paris occupation. Gentlemen, welcome. And
thank you.
Charles, let me just begin with you. I mean, now that you're hearing, we're getting some of the information coming out of this New York Times meeting that Trump has disavowed this particular group. Is that enough for you?
Well, I'm delighted that my Mr. Trump has visited my alma mater at the New York Times and said that he doesn't want to do this anymore, but I want to give him a little advice for the future if he does not want to stimulate the alt-right. First thing, he should never retweet someone with the name White Genocide who lists his address as Jew America. That's what he did in February. He should never ask his supporters again to give the Nazi salute, which he did at a rally in March. That's not a good idea. In July, I think it was a mistake.
Wait, when did he say that?
In March, he asked his supporters to raise and pledge their support to his candidacy and promise to vote for him.
Okay.
There's plenty of video of that. Find that. And then, of course, in July, he retweeted an image of his opponent with the six-pointed Jewish star on it. I thought that was a mistake. But we have bigger problems here. Also in July, you know, he selected as his vice president the most homophobic man in American public life, a person who believes that gay people actually do not have the right to exist. And then, you know, if you don't want to support the alt-right, don't choose as a White House counselor a man who uses the word nigger, whose wife says that he did not want his daughters to go to a school with too many Jews. And don't choose as an attorney general a man who calls the NAACP an un-American organization and who we learned in The Guardian today went so far as to prosecute
Charles,
two of the
just
people.
Hang on a second. I appreciate you going through all of this, but please don't use the N-word on my show.
I'm sorry. Well, I never use the N-word except when I'm quoting someone who's been appointed by the president to serve in the Oval Office, since this is such a disgusting moment in our history.
Let me go back to my original question.
I believe that he's going to be someone who's going to be confirmed. And we can go back and look at everyone's history. I'm sure the person sitting next to me on this program has said some things that he would regret. But we have to look forward.
I think it's shameful that any African-American would support this man to be attorney general. It is
shameful. Sir, you don't know why. You know what? I don't question your allegiance to the people that you support. I will tell you why I support Mr. Trump, who's the president-elect, because I think he's going to do good things for this country and particularly good things for my community.
How do you feel?
All right, gentlemen, we're done. I appreciate both your voices.
You.
I am still, the more I've sat here and listened to the fact that somebody used the N-word on this show, it is not okay. It is not okay, Charles Kaiser. I respect you. I enjoy having you on as a guest, but not okay. By the way, the claim that Mr. Bannon used the N-word, I've never heard of this. So there's